Your Diamondback is built to provide a lifetime of protection for your gear, but you'll want to make sure to get the installation right. Fortunately, the process is simple and we're here to help. There may be a few steps required to get your truck ready, so be sure to read your installation guide carefully. Installing a Diamondback can be done by one person, but it's easier with an extra set of hands. Let's get to it. Unpack your box, being careful not to cut your Diamondback. Open the smaller box that says Start Here. It contains your parts and installation guide, as well as some other useful information. The parts included are 4 gas springs, 4 pieces of bed rail edge trim, a 1/8 hex key, 4 cap clamps, and a bulkhead weatherstrip kit. To get the job done, you'll need a ratchet wrench, a 9/16 socket, a 7/16 socket, and a utility knife. Most truck beds are ready to go from the factory, but yours may require some prep work. Refer to the pre-installation notes on your guide before moving on. Place the center panel across the bed, cheated toward the tailgate. Each panel is tapered front to back, so make sure the arrow on the underside of the panel is pointed in the right direction. To attach the tail panel, hold the panel at a 90-degree angle from the bed rails. Then, begin to mate the driver's side hinge first. It has a longer pin that will make mating the passenger side hinge easier. After mating the second hinge, verify that both hinges are fully engaged before lowering the panel. Repeat these steps for the cab panel, starting this time by sliding the passenger side hinge on first. After you have all 3 panels on the truck, position the cover front to back so that the front of the cab panel lines up with the outside edge of the center of the bulkhead. Next, center the cover side to side on the truck. When you have it in position, attach the center panel by tightening a cap clamp at each of the panel's 4 corners using a 9/16 socket. When you're tightening the clamps, don't overdo it. Over-tightening can damage your bed rail caps, creating an area for water to pool and enter your truck's bed. If you have a torque wrench, it's around 5 to 6 foot-pounds per clamp. After you've tightened each clamp, we recommend one final pass, as some may have loosened from opposing clamps being tightened. You'll want to tighten them just beyond hand tight, to the point where the clamp can't be moved easily by your hand. Give it a week, or a couple hundred miles, for the weather strip to break in, and then retighten. To prevent damage during shipping, these lock rod guide brackets might be pinned up and out of the way. If so, use a 7/16 socket and move one of the bolts to the second unoccupied slot. Repeat this on each of the cover's 4 brackets. For some trucks, the plastic bed rail cap extends below the metal bed rail. If that's the case on your truck, you'll want to trim 2 inches off the bottom of the bed rail cap so that it's flush with the metal bed rail's edge. Do this at each of the 4 points where a lock rod will pass under the rails. Using the provided hex key, loosen the set screws for the tail and cab panel lock rods and re-tighten them after ensuring 3 things. 1. The first bend in the rods point downward, making sure they look like this and not like this. It'll make closing your panels easier and will keep your lock handle working properly. 2. With the lock handle in the open position, the rod tips clear the bed rails. And 3. With the handle in the closed position, the rod tips do not hit the bed walls. Now it's time to tighten things down. For the best weather protection, make sure the weather strip is compressed by applying weight to the cover while you push up and tighten the rod guide brackets using a 7/16 socket. If done properly, your cover may be a little tough to open and close at first. Leave the panels closed as much as possible to allow the weather strip to break in. After 3 days, you'll find things working smoothly and you'll have a great weather protective seal. To make opening and closing your panels easier, apply downward pressure on the panel while turning the lock handle. Now it's time to attach the bed rail edge trim. These pieces will help your lock rods draw the panels down and compress the weather strip. Peel the red adhesive backing from the edge trim pieces and affix them to the metal bed rail at the 4 points where the lock rods pass underneath. The curl of the J should wrap around the bottom edge of the bed rail. Next, you'll want to open the cab panel and have a second person support it in the open position. Loop the end of the cable tethers around the ball stud arms, making sure to go beyond the ball stud and nut. Now, you'll attach 2 gas springs to the cab panel. Make sure the barrel end is up. If you install your gas springs upside down, they'll fail. If 2 of your gas springs have heavier poundage printed on them, use them here. If just one of the springs is heavier, use it on the driver's side. To attach the safety catch, pull down on the panel and push the keyhole at the bottom of the safety catch around the nut. With the safety catch in place, turning your lock handle will only allow your panel to partially open. To fully open the panel, pull down while using your hand to push up on the flat part of the catch. Now, attach the two remaining gas springs on the tail panel. Again, making sure the barrel end is up. We recommend leaving the cover closed and locked for 24 hours to allow the pressure-sensitive weather strip adhesive to fully cure. Aside from that, you're ready for the next adventure, project, or whatever comes your way.